here's my first impressions on this. I haven't had the most time, a lot of rounds through it. Maybe about 300-400 rounds. First impressions. Boy, it's heavy. It's definitely heavy. There's quality in this build, but it's definitely not your BCM lightweight. This is gonna feel like 416 when you pick it up. The weight is just in different areas in this that kind of make it a little bit more balanced. One thing that's different from this versus the 416 is the 416 has kind of harsh recoil. This one doesn't have nearly as bad a recoil. I've never seen forged aluminum like this before, so I'm not sure if this is billet or forged. The Enel CR223, or will be soon known as the BNT BT15. Obviously this has key mod. That's from Enel. When the BNTs start coming into, you know, the States, they'll have M-Lock. And, you know, to be honest, it's super easy to get this off with this QD system. Another thing about this, the trigger. At first, you don't like the trigger until you realize it's kind of a heavy trigger, but then once you get on the reset's really nice and clean on this. So it definitely allows for some pretty good follow-up shots. For a 10.5, the concussion from this thing is rough. You feel it. Maybe it's been a while since I shot a normal 10.5, but who knows what does that, but boy, I can feel it through my ear pro. Also, the exit diameter on the bolt carrier group isn't your typical diameter on that as well, so a Law Tactical folder will not work on this. Ask me how I know. But yeah, when these come into town from BNT, definitely look out for them. If you're trying to grab an AR that's a little bit different, kind of like a 416, but a little bit more modernized, definitely take a look at these Enel CR223s if there's any left in the market. But if not, wait, you won't have to wait too long, but when the BNT BT15s come to town, definitely pick them up.